Hey guys, I'm Paul Bridgewater. Welcome to SnapComms, where we bring you news in a snap. In today's news, Premier the Honorable Andrew A. Fahie is reinforcing his commitment to the people of this territory following the swearing in of his cabinet and junior ministers on March 1st. The appointments are as follows. Premier and Minister of Finance, Honorable Andrew A. Fahie, Minister for Health and Social Development, Honorable Carvin Malone, Minister for Transportation, Works and Utilities, Honorable Kai Reimer, Minister for Natural Resources, Labor and Immigration, Honorable Vincent Wheatley, Minister for Education, Culture, Youth Affairs, Fisheries and Agriculture, Dr. the Honorable Natalia Wheatley, Junior Minister for Trade and Economic Development, Honorable Sherry DeCastro, and Junior Minister for Tourism, Honorable Shireen Flex Charles. Premier Fahie said the new ministerial assignments will strengthen the government's ability to deliver on their agenda for the territory. He said, "The BVI is blessed with untold potential, talented people, and of course, some of the most beautiful natural environments that can be found anywhere in the world. The new government will protect, harness, develop, and promote all that is good about the BVI, both domestically but also on the international stage." Premier Fahie said, "A sound economy will be vital for the government to be able to implement its plans." He said the territory's financial services industry was vital to the recovery of the government revenues following the hurricanes at a time when the tourism industry had been devastated. The Premier added that the BVI still faces continued challenges in the international arena, and the government will continue to work closely with the industry and regulators to ensure that this sector continues to thrive. Premier Fahie said following the passage of the Economic Substance Act, many more opportunities for employment are expected and that there will be discussions with the industry on how these can be maximized to the benefit of BVI landowners. The Premier went on to say, "The rebuilding and expansion of our tourism industry will be a major focus. It is essential that our industry is made resilient and sustainable in order to face the climate change challenges that we will undoubtedly face. This will require significant infrastructure investment, and proposals in this area will be a priority for your new government. I am truly honored and humbled by the confidence placed in me and the entire Virgin Islands Party team. I will carry this great responsibility forward with integrity, and I will always strive to do what's best for the BVI and its people. Let us move forward together in one direction, forward, as one people and as a united Virgin Islands." In other news, new and renewing food handlers on Tortola are notified that clinics will be held at the BVI Red Cross Conference Room on the following dates: on March 7th at 8:30 a.m., on March 18th at 5 p.m., on March 21st at 8:30 a.m., and on March 25th at 5 p.m. Persons renewing their food handler certificates are required to present their expired certificates, social security card, work permit, and or picture identification. For more information, please contact the Environmental Health Division at telephone number 468-5110. Remember that you can log on to bvi.gov.vg and open the Media Center to see full details on these stories. That's it for today, guys. I'm Paul Bridgewater signing off. Be sure to tune in for your daily feed of SnapComms, so we bring you news in a snap.
Subscribe to our YouTube channel, Twitter, and Facebook at BVI Government and Instagram at GISBVI.